Remember, boys, take no prisoners, shoot the bastards.
And your motto is, kill the Boche!
And then he'd go with his revolver, kill, kill, kill.
There used to be a saying going round, the only good German was a dead German.
You Boche bastard!
Well, then, Siddharth, are you in any way surprised at the latest evidence of German atrocities?
No, I'm not, because there is, in a perfectly horrifying number of Germans, a deep underlying streak of cruelty, which came very strongly to light in the last war. And the evidence of that has been multiplied a thousandfold in this one.
Then do you believe that there is no such thing as a decent German?
Oh, I certainly believe that there are decent Germans. I've always said so. But I've always said that they were a weak minority and quite ineffective when they were needed. After all, had it been otherwise, the Germans could perfectly well have prevented the Hitler regime from ever coming into power at all. And even when it was there, they could have resisted. There have been very fine resistance movements in all the occupied countries. There's been no sign of a resistance movement in Germany. And what has been done, even in small and weak countries like Denmark and Holland, would have been done in Germany too, had the war been there. The horror and suffering and damage are beyond atonement and beyond repair.
And that's why I stand not only for unconditional surrender, but for the total and permanent abolition of all German armed forces.
You cannot reason with a tiger when your head is in its mouth!
Reparation, of course, there must be to the utmost of human ability. And beyond that, the Germans must naturally submit also to a prolonged period of occupation and control until their neighbours are reliably assured that they're civilised, which is certainly not the case at present. Voluntarily, of course, there would be no atonement. There are no signs of shame or repentance, and that indeed was the case after the last war. There was no repentance then, they were only sorry that they'd been beaten.
Germany's First World War cost mankind, directly and indirectly, 25 million lives. And her second, before we're through, will have cost two, three, perhaps even four times as much. Now a clique can't do that. The disease is national and the cure must be national. Till it's accomplished, and it'll be a long job, the world will never know the only peace worth having. The peace you can take for granted.